Namah Shri Yati Rajaya Vivekananda Suray Sat Chitta Sukha Sarupaya Swamini Tapaharini. A very good morning to the most revered sense, honorable guests, respected representatives of various educational institutions, the ignited minds of the country, and all the excellencies present as the member of the audience. Today, I, Rupam Shukla, a student of Sunrise English Medium School, feel myself honored to stand here on the occasion of 158th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda. This is one of the best opportunities I have ever received in my life so far. My dear brothers and sisters, Ganga is not merely a river. Himalayas are not merely mountains, and Hindut is not merely a religion. On the same note, friends, I must assert, and I think we all will agree with the statement, that Swamiji was not merely a saint. He was, in true sense, a spiritual leader, a great teacher, a patriotic Indian, and one of the best creations of the Almighty indeed. Brethren, let me narrate to you a story which I read in my junior classes. When Swamiji was in the last stages of his life, Sister Nivedita visited him. On seeing her, Swamiji brought sandesh and water for her and welcomed her wholeheartedly. On seeing this, Sister Nivedita couldn't resist herself from saying, "Prabhuji, what are you doing? You must rest." He replied that this is what every guru must do. He used to care for each and every human being. We know that he sacrificed everything for God. He left everything. But he even left the home, for he left everything just for the service of mankind. Friends, such was our Swamiji, our guru, our teacher. He used to say, "My name should not be made prominent. It is my ideas that I want to be realized." And we must remember that ideas comes from vision and dreams, which in turn gives rise to action. Swamiji dreamt of making India the world leader, and he performed everything that was possible for him to turn his dreams into reality. Even Mahatma Gandhi once said that it is the idea of Swamiji which made me realize that I must do something for India. Just imagine what a personality he was, that even after more than 100 years of Swamiji's living the world, we are celebrating his birth anniversary. However stylish or fashionable a person is in today's world, but each and every head bows down out of respect even on hearing the name of Swamiji. Such was his personality. When Swamiji started to give the message in the entire world, India was under the British rule. And in that adverse conditions, Swamiji left no stones unturned in trying to making his dreams into reality. What a brave soul he had been. He believed that Bharat Mata is the supreme source of human empowerment, and he did everything to turn his dreams into reality. But he has also left a myriad work for us, especially for the youth. He believed that the future of this country depends on the youth. He has given us the task for next 1500 years. But friends, unfortunately, we are not heading towards them. Even after the 117 years of Swamiji's living this world, we couldn't make our way towards making India the superpower. But there is a saying, it's better late than never. And there can be no better day than Swamiji's birthday to realize his dreams and convert it into reality. Friends, we must take pledge that wherever we are, we will devote ourselves towards the progress of the country. We must remember that whatever we do, it should not harm the dignity of our country. And wherever we are, we should not get detached from journalism, from spiritualism, because that's what APJ Abdul Kalam said, a person who gets detached from spiritualism starts regressing. And what else should I say about Swamiji? It's like showing you all this sun by means of a lamp or a torch. But I must say, Swamiji did not only rise to the top, but he also maintained his position. With this, I rest my speech. I hope that we will soon realize the dreams of Swamiji. May Swamiji bless us all, and may we all prosper in every stride of our lives. Thank you.